It was a cool and overcast late summer morning on the home world when we departed St. Joe for a two-day passage to Sturgeon Bay. As nightfall approached, rough seas dampened our enthusiasm for overnight sailing, so we changed course to find a safe harbor. It was dark and the shore was getting close when we discovered an autopilot malfunction had taken us off course. From then on, we dead-reckoned our way to the Holland pierhead and located a dockage in the marina's launch well. Next morning, it was the Labor Day holiday, and there was a sense of leisure in the air as we made way to the shipyard office. The staff was cool with our scene, so we decided to stop over and make some repairs. And with that diplomatic formality out of the way, a self-tour of this first-class facility was in order. The Eldian shipyard recognized our alliance with the Empire and honored Fesarius with slip D7, reserved for Klingon battle cruisers. With navigation back online, Fesarius had a new mission. Unfavorable winds scuttled plans for Sturgeon Bay, so we're southbound to the homeworld, where we will stage for a Chicago passage in the morning. The winds that changed our plans are now astern, so with a pleasant following sea, it was time to dress the ship in honor of the Empire and test fire our new supply of bubble photons. It was a glorious day of downwind sailing, and once home the crew relaxed, told stories of great adventures, and planned for tomorrow's departure. Crossing Lake Michigan is an all-day project, so we're underway at nautical twilight. The north winds are now on the starboard beam, and with a lightly rolling sea, Fesarius just sails comfortably to Chicago at 6.5 knots. It's the balance you get once in a while that brings out the yacht in this boat. So there really isn't much to do but occasionally trim the sails and enjoy the ride. About 20 miles from Chicago, another traveler sat down on the deck to take a rest. There are two first sighting events on a crossing, the tallest buildings of the city and the outer lighthouses. As you sail toward Chicago between these events, the skyline starts to consume the horizon, and soon you feel the gravity of the windy city. We had a slip reservation at Burnham Harbor, which is located within walking distance to downtown and the museum campus. So shortly after the ship was secured, a landing party went ashore to sample the local cuisine. Returning dockside, music filled the marina from nearby Huntington Bank Pavilion, where Florence and the Machine was performing. It seemed logical to beverage up and enjoy a free concert on the aft deck. Thursday morning, the crew was in fine spirits, So Fesarius headed out for a day of yachting along the never-disappointing Chicago skyline. There's a great network of bike and pedestrian trails that extend several miles along the waterfront and into the city. E-bikes and scooters are easily accessible, and in no time you can hop a ride to dining and attractions. After enjoying 2 days of Chicago hospitality, Fesarius departs under calm winds and heads east towards Michigan City. The day offered little wind, and crossing was a division of thirds. It was 2 hours of sailing, 2 hours of motor sailing, and 2 hours of motoring. The 680 megawatt Michigan City Generating Station is a well-referenced navigational feature when sailing in southern Lake Michigan, but that soon will change. The plant is scheduled to shut down in 2028, and its demolition will free up approximately 1 mile of lakefront space. The adjacent Michigan City Port Authority is a fine marina with reasonable overnight rates and is walking distance to restaurants and nightlife. With barely a puff of breeze, we brought the engine online and took a shoreline sightseeing cruise on our return to the home world. Every journey changes you. It leaves marks on your memory, on your consciousness, on your heart, and it turns you into a storyteller about being aboard the flagship Fesarius.